Hi students, how are you? Today we'll discuss about the second part of the population growth. Myself, Tonmoy Dotto, Assistant Professor, JIS College of Engineering, Kollam. You know, in the previous class, we already discussed about the exponential growth model. But there was some problems or the result was not according to the practical scenario. That's why we need some another model which will be most or more appropriate to the practical scenario. So that's why there was a more logical theory or logical concept that is called logistic growth model. So today we'll discuss about the logistic growth model. Okay. Second thing, we'll discuss the each and every area of the curve of the logistic growth equation. Okay, the curve corresponding to the logistic growth equation. Third, we'll discuss about the what are the differences between exponential growth model and the logistic growth model. Then we'll discuss about the maximum sustainable yield. What is the maximum sustainable yield or what is the condition? Then we'll discuss about the maximum sustainable yield. Then we'll discuss about the some numerical problems. Or from the exponential growth model or maybe logistic growth model. So then we'll discuss about the problems, numerical problems from the different types of equation which we already discussed. Okay, so these are the today's topic, logistic growth model, its curve, difference between exponential growth model and logistic growth model, then maximum sustainable yield, and the last we'll discuss about the few problems from the topic or from the population growth. Okay, so I will start the today's class. So just for a recapitulation purpose, so in the previous class we discussed about the exponential growth rate equation, and this is the exponential growth rate equation which we discussed in the previous class, like d into dt that equals to r into capital R was the exponential growth model. And then we discussed about the doubling time of population td, and then we discussed about the half life time of population. Okay, so this was the equation, and then we develop some relation between the doubling time of population and the half-life time of population. And after that we discussed about the graph of the exponential graph, means which graph we obtained according to the exponential growth rate equation. And then there are some limitations of the exponential growth curve, that's why we are unable to explain some factors, or this is not actually the practical according to the practical scenario, so that's why the graph is not suitable, or the graph is not according to the practical scenario. So that's why we have to think about the another model, and that's why today we'll discuss about the another model which is more logical with respect to the exponential growth curve, and this is the logistic growth curve or logistic growth equation. So logistic growth curve is looks like almost this type of looks here for logistic growth curve. But before that we have to know about the what is the logistic growth rate equation. Okay, so when we consider the logistic growth rate equation, so look here that in case of logistic growth rate equation here, dn dt. Okay, so what is the dn dt, you have to know at first. So here we are considering that at the time t, the population of that particular place is the n. Okay, this we have to consider, that at the time t, any time in the previous case, like in case of exponential growth model, we considered that at the time t their population was nt, but here we are considering at the time t population was n. Okay, so that's why dn dt that express the change of population with time. So rate of change of population with time or population growth, that is represented by dN dt. Now here there is another term and most important term, that is the small r. What is the small r? Small r is the here it is the logistic growth rate constant. Okay, so here smaller is the logistic growth rate constant. I told you that in the capital R, in case of exponential growth model, we took capital R as the exponential growth rate constant, but here we are taking smaller as the logistic growth rate constant. Okay, so you have to keep in mind that logistic smaller here constant, that is the logistic growth rate constant. What is the n? I already discussed with you. Now the most important thing is that here what is the k? Okay, so final equation is the dN dt equals to this is the final equation of the your logistic growth rate constant. So you have to know the equation, and here what is the k? You have to know what is the k. So k is called actually carrying capacity of the environment. What is the carrying capacity of the environment? You know, each and every system of our universe, each and every system, it has its maximum capacity. If you think about a glass, then this glass has the maximum capacity of carrying the water. If you put the water above its maximum or beyond its maximum capacity, then the water will be overflow. Isn't it? In case of environment also, same case. Our environment, here environment means we consider a particular region. Okay, so if we consider a particular region, then what happen? This particular region, there is a maximum capacity of the population, maximum number of the population, and that population can stay there comfortably up to a particular limit. If the area is overpopulated, like there are some parts of the Kolkata, you know, these parts are overpopulated, so that's why in this area there are different kinds of problem arised. So that's why these parts are called the overpopulated area. Okay, so now k actually the limit up to which one particular area can carry the population. Okay, so that number k is the number, up to that number one particular area the population can stay there comfortably. If there the population is beyond k, then there will be some kinds of problem will generate in that particular area. Okay, so this k is very very important here. You have to keep in mind the significance of k. And what I told you in the previous class, that there is something of which is missing in the exponential growth model, and this was actually k. Okay, so here we are considering the k, and this makes the difference with respect to the exponential growth model and the logistic growth model. Okay, so now if we come to the equation, then there are three parts of the if we consider the growth curve, then according to this equation there are the growth curve looks like, okay, this is looks like a almost S pattern. Okay, so but this S pattern, there is a three region of the S pattern. Okay, so first region, look here, that A to B, I will discuss each and every area in details. So first area, look here, A to B. Okay, so A to B, that looks like almost exponentially increase. Okay, so A to B looks like almost exponentially increased. Okay, and B to C, look here, there is a steady increasing of the population. Okay, if you think about B to C, there is a steady increasing of the population. Okay, and C to D, the rate of the population almost it decreases. Okay, decreases or not decreases, almost it same, it is not increasing so much. Okay, population, the rate of increasing population is not here so much higher, the rate is quite low, rate of increasing the population is quite low. And look here, up to that level, this is the actually k. Okay, so k means up to that point the environment can carry the population comfortably. So k is the here up to that level k is called the maximum carrying capacity of the environment. Why maximum? Because up to look here, up to this level environment can carry the population comfortably, no problem. Okay, so here this axis population axis, as you know, like the previous case, and the this axis actually called the time axis. Okay, so with respect to n is the population, n means population, t means time here, and k is the number of population where it reaches the maximum value, and here it is a k by 2, that means half of the maximum population. Okay, in this region it is the half of the maximum population. So just keep in mind that what is the A to B, it is the first scenario. Okay, when the population admits, this is the starting time, exactly this is the starting time when we are considering the A to B, the starting time. So in this time the population is very very low. Okay, B to C, middle time, the population steadily increases, and C to D, it is the almost near equal to saturation. What is the saturation? I will discuss each and every part. Okay, so if we consider the first part, that means the A to B, in A to B part, here the population n by k near equal to zero. Okay, why n by k near equal to zero in A to B? Look here, why n by k near equal to zero? Because here n by k near equal to zero, because look here n actually very very less than k. Why n very very less than k? Because look here, it is the first time k, if you look the graph here, so look here that n means it's the first time. So if you take any value of n here, then it is obviously very very less than k. This value is very very less than with respect to k, so that's why we are taking it as the n very very less than k. And if n very very less than k, obviously n by k, this will be near equal to zero, because if k is very very high, so the value will be 0.00000 something. So that's why we are taking it as a zero. Now if n by k near equal to zero, then the equation, this equation reduces to put here the value of n by k near equal to zero, the equation reduces to only dnt by dt equals to rn. So look here, dnt by dt equals to rn. So the dnt by dt equals to rn means dn dt proportional to n. And just remember, dn dt proportional to n, this equation looks like exponential growth model equation. Previous class, only their difference was we took the initial population nt, and here we are taking the population n as the first time. So that is the only difference. And that's why if you carefully look at the first time, also population is increasing exponentially. At the A to B, population is increasing here exponentially. Okay, so another way we can explain this fact, that at the first time, look here, there's a huge amount of the resources available in that particular area, because with increasing the time, the resource will be consumed by the population, that's why resource will be decreases. So but at the first time, there's a huge resource, very very less number of population, so that's why population increasing very high rate. Okay, but if you think about the second region, that means here in the second region, this is the B to C, this looks like a straight line, almost this looks like a straight line in case of B to C. So if it is a straight line, you know, it is n versus t. Okay, it is the n versus t. So if it is the straight line, then obviously we can write down that dn dt equals to constant, you know, it is the equation of the straight line. So dn dt equals to constant. So if dn dt equals to constant, that indicate that the population is, now come to the point that what is the dn dt? So dn dt means here it is the rate of change of population with time. In the second case, B to C, so it is the rate of change of population with time. So if it is the rate of change of population with time, then what happened? Then we can tell that in the middle time, there is a proportionality between the resource and the population. And that's why the rate of change of population with time, that is actually fixed. Okay, so that means population, this is increasing in a constant rate or in a particular rate. Okay, so this is also important second portion. Now come to the third portion. So if you think about the third portion there, if you take any value here, then we can tell that for C2D that n near equals to k. If here n near equals to k, we can write down n by k that near equals to 1, isn't it? So third portion, look here, if you take any value in this region, then n by k or n near equal to k, so n by k the value will be near equal to 1. Now if n by k this value near equal to 1, then come to that point, then what happened in the equation? If you put here n by k value 1, the equation reduces to the equation here reduces to only dn dt equals to 0, because if n by k 1 minus 1 that will be 0, 1 minus 1 0 means dn dt equals to 0. So look here, so that's why here in case of C2D, in case of look here C2D there, dn dt equals to 0. If dn dt equals to 0, we can write down n equals to constant. If n equals to constant, then this indicate that population increasing almost there stopped. So why stop? Then come to the point that it is the near equal to the region of the k, and k is the maximum limit. Okay, so when the population come to the near equal to point of the maximum population, when the population come to the reach to the near exactly almost similar or same value of the maximum carrying capacity of the population, then what happened? The population it almost looks like stopped increasing. The population become constant. So C2D or near equal to D, then population increasing is totally stopped, population become constant. Now come to the point of what will be after D. What will be if after D, what will be the scenario? Look here, after D, if we think about here, after D, what happened? Here after D, generally if up to that point here is the k, so after D what happened? It is the expected that after D it will be the n that equals to that greater than k. After D what happened? Because after D means D is the point of k, so if we consider the after D, then obviously n greater than k. So if n greater than k, then what happened? If n greater than k, then we can take it as the, so if n greater than k, then what happened? We can write down that n by k that greater than 1, isn't it? So if n greater than k, that indicate n by k greater than 1. Now if you look the equation, then what happened? If you look the equation, if n by k greater than 1, then 1 minus something which is bigger than 1, then 1 minus something which is bigger than 1. So 1 minus something which is bigger than 1, that indicate that dn dt equals to negative value. Okay, so dn dt negative means, what is the meaning of dn dt negative? Dn dt negative means here population will be decreased, dn dt that equals to negative value. Now dn dt negative means population will be decreased with time. So that is the main theory behind the all the discussion. Okay, that when the maximum population reach to its maximum limit, the population increasing will be stopped. Instead of increasing, the population will start to decrease to maintain the balance. There are different kinds of ways by which our environment always try to maintain the balance. But what happened? Due to different kinds of humans' activity, sometimes environment is also unable to maintain the balance. Okay, so there are some kinds of natural calamities by which environment try to decrease the pollution. All of you know very well, like tsunami, like earthquake, like etc. etc. By which environment try to maintain the balance. There are some kinds of social problem also. When in a particular region, their population will be very high or it reach the maximum capacity, then different kinds of problems started. That's why to decrease the population. So by this way, environment try to decrease the population. So that's why theoretically or sometimes practically also after D, there are some kinds of problems arise, and that's why at least people will not be at that place, will not be able to stay at that place comfortably. Okay, so this is the overall discussion of the logistic growth curve. Now if we try to discuss about what are the differences between exponential growth curve and the logistic growth curve, okay, what will be the differences? Okay, so now if we want to differentiate between exponential and logistic growth model, then first point will be in case of exponential growth model, look, there is no concept of the K. That means there we did not consider the maximum carrying capacity of the environment, or we ignore the maximum carrying capacity of the environment. But in case of logistic growth rate, here we consider the maximum carrying capacity of the environment. And actually, you know, this maximum carrying capacity make the difference in the result of the exponential growth model and the logistic growth model. Second point, in exponential growth model, actually we get the absurd result or illogical result. Okay, so here we are getting the absurd or illogical result. But in case of a logistic growth model, here we'll get the concept of the more logical, okay, or more accurate result. So logistic growth model gives us more logical result. Okay, so here we are getting the more logical result. Okay, so this is the second difference between exponential growth model and the logistic growth model. And third, obviously the third difference will be in exponential growth model, here the curve will be increasing. Okay, this will be exponential curve, but here the curve will not be increasing, it will be looks like S shape. Okay, and third point, you can write down the equation. Okay, the equation of the exponential growth model, here dN dt equals to, you know, rn, but here dN dt equals to rn 1 minus n by k, as we discussed previously. So here you have to maintain all the points of one by one, what are the differences between exponential growth model and the logistic growth model. Now we'll move to the next topic, and it will be a numerical problem which you have to solve. Okay, so students, what you have to do, you have to take a screenshot of the problem, or you can write down in your copy about the problem, then you have to solve it. Just pause the video, just try to solve the problem, then when I will discuss, then check your answer or your process is either right or either match with my answer or discussion or not. Okay, so what is the problem? So in case of problem, it is given in the problem that it is mentioned in the question. Suppose that human population follows human population took 200 years, okay, 200 years for the population to increase the population from 1 million to 10 million. Okay, so this is given in the question. So here what information is given, that human population took 200 years to increase the population from 1 million to 10 million. This is given. Okay, so now you have to find out the exponential growth rate constant. That means you have to find out what will be the value of R if it follow exponential growth model. So that exponential, if it followed exponential growth model, okay, so if it follow the exponential growth model, then you have to find out what will be the value of R, okay, exponential growth rate constant. Okay, so these values are given to you, okay, these all the values are given to you, so you have to find out that what will be the answer or the solution of the problem. Okay, so simply what you have to do, you have to write down the equation that what we discussed today, that nt equals to n0 into e to the power rt that we already discussed. Okay, so here already given that nt equals to 200, sorry, nt equals to 10 million. Okay, so nt equals to 10 million. So simply we will write down that nt equals to 10 million because human population follows, it will be 1 million to 10 million. So obviously it will be 10 million. Okay, so 10 million and n0 equal to 1 million. So n0 equal to 1 million. Then e to the power, we have to find out r, and it is given that t equals to 200 years. Okay, so t equals to 200 years. So these all the values are given, and from here we'll get that r equals to, what will be the r? So r value, just keep in mind, you have to find out the r value in the percentage. Okay, so always you have to keep in mind that formula. So r equal to, you will get, so what value you will get here, then you have to, so for example it will be 2.303 by 200, then you have to multiply with 100, okay, because you have to find out the value of R in the percentage. Then finally we will get, what will be the answer? The answer will be 1.15%. Okay, so this will be the answer, 1.15%. okay, so here that answer you have to check either you are getting this answer or not. Okay, so this is the answer of the question, and this is very simple question. So this type of numerical problem you have to solve during the if you face any kind of numerical problem from here. Okay, so now we'll move to the, so you have to check other types of numerical problems also. In any of the standard book you can find out so many types of numerical problems, so which you have to solve. Okay, so now we'll move to the next topic, and the next topic is that maximum sustainable yield. Okay, so you have to concentrate here because this is very very important thing. So we'll discuss about the last topic of the population growth, that is the maximum sustainable yield. Okay, so it is the maximum sustainable yield. Okay, so now what is the maximum sustainable yield? Maximum sustainable yield means it is the maximum rate at which individuals of an ecosystem can be removed without reducing the population size. Okay, that means it is the maximum rate when the growth follows the maximum rate. At that rate, if we remove any individuals from the ecosystem, there will be no effect in the population size or no effect on the rate actually. So if there is a term maximum, so in case of maximum, you know that the derivative of the rate will be zero. So if we write down the derivative, that means d dt of dn dt, the rate of the, you know, the rate of the equation. So d dt of dn dt, that equals to zero. We can write down for maximum sustainable yield. So from that equation, we can also write down d dt of, just put here the values of the dn dt, that will be r n, as you know, dn dt equals to 1 minus n by k. So obviously that equals to zero, isn't it? So that equals to zero. So if this equation follows the zero, you know, for maximum and minimum case, this will be zero, the rate will be, the derivative of the rate will be zero. And in this way, if you calculate it, then you will find out from here n equals to k by n equals to k by 2. And n equals to k by 2, this is the equation or this is the condition at which we can achieve the maximum sustainable yield. Now try to understand what is the n is equal to k by 2. N is equal to k by 2 means it is the population when the population is the half of the maximum carrying capacity of the environment. You know, k is the maximum carrying capacity of the environment. So n equals to k by 2 means it is the maximum carrying capacity of the environment. So when the population of any place is in that situation, then we can achieve the maximum sustainable yield. That means at this moment, if we remove any individuals from the ecosystem, there will be no effect in the ecosystem. Okay, so this is all about your population growth. So previously we discussed about the exponential growth rate, and today we already discussed about the logistic growth rate. Then we discussed about the logistic growth rate. Then we discussed about the after logistic growth rate, then we discussed about the what are the difference between exponential growth rate and the logistic growth rate. Then there are some numerical problems which we solve, okay, and some numerical problems, and finally maximum sustainable yield, that also we discussed. Okay, so from there, so many types of questions you can expect, starting from the very important question is that you may explain the graph of the logistic growth model. This is very, very important. That means the different area you have to explain. The question may arise in that way, what are the differences between exponential growth model and logistic growth model. There may be some kinds of numerical problems you can expect, or there may be some kinds of question regarding the maximum sustainable yield. Okay, maximum sustainable, you can expect such kind of question there, maximum sustainable yield. Okay, so this type of question you can expect from here, and that's all about your population growth chapter. Okay, so we'll meet with you in the next class with a new topic. Okay, so thanks to all of you for attending my class. Okay, goodbye.